at MISUMI, we offer such a wide variety of coupling types. So how will you know which type suits your application? You'll find the answer to that question right now on Engineer to Engineer. Welcome to our new series, Engineer to Engineer. I'm Matt McMaster, and today, our Senior Motion Systems Application Engineer, Chuck Leonard, will be demonstrating coupling selection for our linear guides and linear actuators. You'll also be learning about a few different coupling types, as well as which types will work best for your applications, as Chuck shows you just how much flexibility various couplings allow for when torque is applied. So let's go join Chuck.
Hello, my name's Chuck Leonard. I'm the Senior Motion Systems Application Engineer here at MISUMI, and today we're going to talk about coupling selection for our linear guides and linear actuators. MISUMI offers a wide variety of different types of couplings, from a simple rigid type coupling similar to this, to our standard Oldham coupling, which has a plastic spiders inside of it. And then we have a variety of universal joint type couplings, some very large clamping type couplings, simple bellows couplings, down to very small, simple little plastic couplings. But primarily what we're looking at today and we're going to discuss is the type of coupling that we would use on a linear actuator. Now, primarily what a linear actuator does is it transfers rotary motion to linear motion. So inside of this unit, we've got a screw that's going to be moving back and forth. What we're going to do is we would attach a motor to this end of the unit. What we need now is, because we've got a shaft on our motor and we have a shaft on our actuator, we need to be able to have a coupling that's going to be able to fit within our motor frame here. So this is one of our first criteria. And then we also need to know what our shaft diameters are for our actuator shaft and what the shaft diameter is for our motor. Now, different types of actuators have got different types of pilot openings. This is our LX45. It's one of our largest units, and you can stick up to a 32 to 40 millimeter diameter coupling inside of this. Well, most of our couplings, the way they're rated, we've got a variety of these. A lot of people like to use this slit type coupling on actuators. It's got very high precision, and it also has very good repeatability with a fair amount of torque. Now, one thing a coupling does is it allows you to have just a little bit of misalignment or angular difference between the actual two motor shafts that you might have that are moving. Now, this misalignment, this coupling can account for it. Now, if you were to use something like a rigid coupling, which is primarily just a coupling that is a piece of solid metal and it's made to clamp down on your two shafts. This type of coupling has no misalignment capabilities, but it's got the advantage that it's going to have very high repeatability and it's also going to have very high torque transfer. Where if you were to go with something like our Oldham coupling, which has got a whole lot of flexibility in this as far as angular misalignment, you can get 2 to 3, 4 degrees worth of misalignment with this coupling. But you're going to have a problem in here that it's got a lot of flexibility too. And then if you're looking for precision repeatability on your actuator, as your motors reverse and go forward, you're going to end up with flexibility inside of the coupling. And in the bellows, we have a similar issue here. We have a lot of flexibility in this thing. But the thing with a coupling like this, it's not going to transfer a lot of torque. The bellows is very good in that it does very good repeatability, but it doesn't have a very high torque rating on it. Now, a couple of things we talk about now for a very high torque. This is what we call a disc-type coupling. And what this coupling has in it, you've got a components here that are actually mounted together with flat spring discs that are riveted between the coupling. It allows for about a 1 to 2 degree misalignment, but it has very high torque transfer, and these discs are very, very good for repeatability because they're not very flexible. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to hook it up. This is a little jigging fixture that we've put together, and primarily what we can do with this thing is I can take one of our couplings, and I can mount it inside of this fixture, and we'll set it up here. Now, all these couplings I have here use a clamping type coupling. We also offer couplings with set screw sets or keyed couplings. The difference between these, the set screw actually digs into the shaft and it can make it a little difficult to remove, where a clamping type actually just clamps around the shaft so it doesn't mar the shaft up. Another type of coupling is a keyway coupling. Now, the advantage of a keyway is you physically have a piece of metal that creates a key between the coupling and the shaft. And it also, it keeps it from turning. About the only disadvantage of those on the keyway is that you have to have the proper size key for the type of coupling that you're using. So what I'm going to do is I've got a torque wrench here. Now, if you'll notice, this needle is set just about on zero. Now, we've got a torque wrench that we've set up. It's got a small gauge on it, and we can record the actual amount of force that I apply on this unit, and then we can take and actually measure what we're going to see as flexibility in this coupling. So if I run this unit out, we're going to put about 20 newton meters of force on this coupling. This is way above the range that it would normally do, but you can see that we're actually flexing this coupling at about 20 degrees. So this would be play that would be in your system, and this would not be desirable for a very high precision type system. Now, it does have some advantages if you're using this on a motor and you were doing quick and short stops and starts on your motor and you wanted to absorb some of that shock in the system. That's where an Oldham coupling would fall in. Now, I'm going to take this coupling off and we'll replace it back with a disc type coupling. All right, I've mounted this second coupling on her. Now, this is our disc type coupling. It's got the two discs that are riveted to the outer clamping parts of the shaft coupling. Now, I'm going to reset my gauge here. And I'm going to try to get about the same amount of force. We're going to go up to about 20 newton meters. Oh, I got slippage. All right, I've remounted our coupling here. Now we've got our split type coupling here where it's got the disc plates in it. It's about a 10 millimeter coupling. And I'm going to apply about the same amount of force. Now these couplings that I'm using are rated for about 1 to 25 newton meters of force, depending on the unit. I'm actually going to run this above its force rating. So we're going to run this one on up to about 20 newton meters again. So as I apply the force to it, we're going to hit about 20 newton meters here. You can see I'm not really moving that needle at all. So we've got some pretty high-end torque. Now what this gives you here, and what this torque's going to relate to with this type of system, if you have a lot of flexibility between your motor and your coupling and your shaft, you're going to get different positions on this actuator as it moves. And the whole design behind one of these actuators is to have it very precise so that as you put the number of pulses to rotate this motor, the repeatability of this actuator repeats back to exactly the same place at every single time. And depending on the type of actuator that you get, we have repeatability as high as 3 microns on these actuators. Standard actuators will repeat up to about 5 micron repeatability. But that repeatability is dependent on you having the proper type of coupling tied to your motor and your motor shaft that is properly tightened and not slipping. So, again, a lot of times when you go into the different types of couplings and people look at these and they say, well, what type of coupling do you use? The Oldham's type coupling, like I said, is fairly standard for single direction motor type use. The bellows is very flexible and very repeatable, but it's not going to put out a lot of torque. Our slit type coupling, it's a very repeatable coupling. It can take a modest amount of torque, but will not allow for any misalignment whatsoever. It will fracture the unit. We have our rigid type coupling. Now the rigid type coupling is an extremely good coupling. It's got a lot of capabilities as far as torque transfer, but it has to have absolute alignment of both shafts. And then we get back into our double disc and single disc type alignments. The double disc will give you the more flexibility, but it gives you the reasonable amount of flexibility with the shaft. But it gives you that high repeatability and high torque transfer that you're looking for rapid movement and very high and precision placement of your linear actuator.
Well, that does it for this episode of Engineer to Engineer. If you'd like to check out our wide variety of couplings, go to MISUMIUSA.com and type couplings into the search box. If you have any questions about our couplings or any of our other products, simply post it on one of our social media outlets. That way, everybody can see your question as well as our answer. You can find the links to those in the description below. Also, check out our new blog, the MISUMI Mech Lab, where we post weekly articles about products, applications, and tons of other great content. If you found this video helpful, hit the thumbs up button, and also be sure to subscribe to our channel to stay up to date on all of our brand new content. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time.